Alright, so this one. Casting a spalted river birch, curly knot that's hollow. My idea is to go for blue dye, yellow mica, which will give it blue and yellow and some green, and then a yellow dye and blue mica, which would reverse the effect. Hoping. In my last video, I started doing it by volume on clear slow, and I was, oops, not the right thing to do. So since I've got to get my colors right, I'm gonna do part A first, write down my weight, get my color right, go back and do part B, that I would have time to mix together, cast, and get in the pot. Because when I'm playing with my colors, I'll get it more darker than what I want it. That way, when I add more epoxy, it'll become lighter. I don't know how much it's gonna take, so we're just gonna roll with it. A pound each, which will give us So by now you can tell that I'm in a rush to seriously make up some more resin. I was a little shy, and even after I mixed some up and poured some more in there, the wood being punky sucked up some of the resin and still came up short, but you can see that it's done rose up a little bit right there, and you'll see it really float up. I had it in that mold pretty good to where it wouldn't rise up, but it still came up. So that piece of white right there is just some HDP plastic that I had and taped it down. And this right here is just a preview of how it came out. I went ahead and cut the corners off so it wouldn't be square. It helps. Plus, I saved my leftover pieces for future projects. We'll be right back.
So when I cut this off, instead of making a separate piece, I decided to just use the part that was for the tenon and the leftover wood that was already the same thing, cast in the same epoxy. Decided to make it into the cap for it. And that worked out pretty well, except for the fact that when I swapped to my 2-inch jaws and made the hole in the top, as you see right here, didn't fit. Had to back up and punt yet again.